ninth shutout during your time as a head coach, first in 6 years. Let's just start there. What a tremendous performance by your defense today.
It was. Really, the first half was a dominant performance and had two fourth down stops. And then really, I don't know if we stopped them on this one fourth down in the second half when they dropped the ball, but they played with a lot of confidence. We got a lot of guys some playing time. So Malik Lofton reminded me in the locker, we can play better, but we'll take the 44-0 win.
Well, and defensively, because you dominated the first half, you had the ball in Indiana State territory virtually the whole first half, but you have the one possession where you punt, you have a field goal block, so they're still very much in that game until that Adam Bach interception. Really seemed like that turned the momentum.
It did. Yeah, it did. In fact, I think we set ourselves back by not completing a couple of those drives or the field goal or whatever, but again, in football, certain plays energize you, and that box interception really got us going.
And once your offense got rolling, there were a number of guys involved, but man, you guys got into a rhythm because you score on six consecutive possessions.
Yeah, you know, and I don't want to ever be on the other end of that. You know, that's got to be a tough, tough situation for the opponent. I really respect Coach Mallory and what he's doing here, and you know, but there's nothing you can do. You run your plays, and once in a while they just click consecutively, and they did in terms of what you're talking about.
Pierre Strong Jr., 20 rushes, 150 yards. We've talked about that he's healthy, but he's got that burst, the way he finds room within the defense. He's playing at another level right now.
He is, and I know he wanted a few of those runs to break. I was really impressed with how they tackled him in the open field because he's very hard to tackle in the open field. But, man, did they give us a lot of looks on defense. So happy with his yards and happy with the win.
We do need to work a little bit on his throwing, though, don't we?
It's a little wobbly, but they're probably only going to use it once a season. So we'll take that one.
Chris Oladokun, 12 of 21, 216 yards, 3 touchdowns passing. We joked a moment ago, obviously, he caught a touchdown pass as well. What'd you think of your grad transfer quarterback today?
Again, he had a ton of different looks. He had a bunch of times where they rushed 3 and dropped 8. Just were really, really varied their approach. I thought he played well. I thought he ran when he could and was smart and slid. He's just a very mature player. Even at this point in our program.
You got a couple of young guys who are only going to get better, which is scary. I want to highlight them in particular. One of them is Tucker Kraft, the job he did today. 5 receptions, 85 yards, and a touchdown. And it just seemed like he and Oladokun really had a connection going this afternoon.
Well, he's a really good player, and I think he hit it on the head. He's only going to get better for two reasons, how young he is and his desire to excel in everything he does. That touchdown down here in the corner was phenomenal. I mean, the guy was draped on him, and he just was strong enough to separate and make the catch and get in the end zone. So I yelled at him to be on his feet on the one play, but he said he did everything he could to stay on his feet. But we'll watch the film.
Well, and then Bach, we mentioned him earlier with the interception, but he had 10 tackles today and the interception and just his level of play as a middle linebacker, knowing that he's got a lot of time left in that yellow and blue.
He's such a special player, and it's not like in our defense. It's real simple, and you just line up and run and tackle. He's got to make a lot of calls and adjustments and do a lot of different things, and he's very smart football-wise. He's very smart in the classroom, and then he's a great football player.
What were you happiest with today?
I think the seconds, when the seconds went in and had success. You know, we've seen in games and seasons where the second, your number two guy becomes the number one, and he's got to believe in himself because we're going to believe in him, and number two, he's got to be ready to play. And there were some bright spots in the Missouri Valley because this is not an easy conference, and that's not a easy football team. So was really excited about that.
What were you most disappointed with today?
Tackling. But at times, whether it was a sack or a running back off the edge, we just didn't wrap up. And I'm a guy that yells, grab cloth, grab flesh, grab something so the guy can't get out. And that's not that hard. And so we're going to work on that this week.
How are you health-wise?
Don's questionable. Don Gardner, we've got to get an X-ray for him, but everything else, I think we're good. You're able to take guys out. They're bruised a little bit because of the score differential, so I think Don's the only guy we got to worry about.
Beef Bowl, it's a tradition at South Dakota State University. I know it's one that's near and dear to your heart. Next Saturday night, and a lot of excitement about it.
Yeah, new opponent for us, night game. Our guys love those. You know, it'll be a good crowd. I love the agriculture and the fact that we're a land-grant university. So a lot of things in my world come to a head or intersect for a game like that. So I can't wait.